We are here with our first webinar. So we welcome all who have turned up, and the numbers are increasing. I hope you have enjoyed the week so far. So I'm just introducing first of all the team. Myself, Dr. Ajay Semanti, as you know, the course coordinator of the SMOKE Academic Writing.
Hello friends, this is Dr. Mona Semanti, course coordinator.
And you might have seen from the plagiarism in the exclusive week, and we are here with us with Lokesh Adhikari. Mr. Lokesh is our core team member and assisting us with all the technical aspects of the course. So friends, we have kept the topic plagiarism for today's discussion. We welcome all your queries. Meanwhile, we will just cover what we have learned together in the plagiarism history. You know, before moving to this particular topic, academic writing, I would like to share with you that this is the course from HNB Gadwal University, which is the Central University of Srinagar Gadwal, Uttarakhand. It is the topmost massive open online course, MOOC, of SWAYAM of last cycle, and ranked worldwide for its popularity. So we were 12,500, more than 12,500 learners from 80 countries in the course of the last cycle, and so far we have crossed 5,800 learners. So dear learners, welcome you in this course from Gadwal University. Now we will start our discussion. That I will take up your questions by seeing the my mobile. Okay, so our the Lokesh will assist us that the, about the questions, whatever the questions are coming in the live interaction board.
Till now, all we have are greetings, good afternoon, and all that. First question is here by Rishikesh Korada. Small doubt regarding self-citing of our paper.
Friends, dear learners, self-citation is a problematic figure actually. Of course, you can self-cite your work, you have done good work, you have got the published work, but you cannot fill all your references or a major portion of your references from your self-citation. Recently, you might have seen the news. If you haven't observed, go to the newspaper. You know, it was a Indian scientist which is based in abroad, who have been found to be guilty of exclusive self-citations, you know, and on the basis of self-citation, his H index was increased.
If it supports logically to the research, then it is okay.
Unnecessarily, if you are putting your reference.
Your individual citations, you can't go for citations.
Like, and it is clear, it is clear in the paper that whether it is rational use or irrational use. When the cell, okay, 1, 2, 3 papers, 4 papers you can cite maybe, depending on the proportion of the number.
It should be completely related to your current paper which you are writing.
And obviously, if you are having only 10 or 15 references, you cannot have the 4, 5, 50% of the reference from yours only. It is the percentage you have to control yours. Okay? So it is a double-edged sword. If you use heavily, it is not a good practice, and nowadays, elsewhere, Springer and Nature are scanning the people who are self-citing and who are promoting self-citation if they are reviewed. No? Some reviewers have also been banned.
If I am citing my PhD guide papers, who is also a co-author in my paper or in my thesis?
The answer is the same.
Self-citation.
The same answer is for the question that it's of your guide. or it's your own paper, like it's related and supports, if you have to write 30 references, so you can cite 2-3 references of your own, and it should completely
co-author they are asking. Yeah. Co-author you won't know. The co-author yes. Obviously the guide will be the co-author.
Self-citation of or citation of co-author, one of the co-author of our paper.
Of course you can have, but
of their previous work.
Obviously this, as ma'am has mentioned, it must be closely relevant, not just relevant. It should be directly linked to the references you are citing, to the topics you are talking about in that particular portion of the paper. Okay.
Next question is, please, is it necessary for one to register his or her text to obtain a copyright? I mean, what is the procedure to get the permission for copyright? Or
copyright, basically, you know, copyright,
is it automatic or something?
Copyright is not automatic, you know, copyright is completely black and white exercise, you know. You will have to sign a letter, you will have to give in writing, it's a complete, a format is there, a copyright agreement is there. Basically, copyright agreement, it is a kind of agreement between you and the publisher, okay? So, and if you are giving copyright, it means it is a copyright of your publisher, not yours. Depends on the agreement which you have signed. Copyright is, you have to sign, but what we have discussed or what we are going to discuss or you might have gone through in the open educational resources, that crash course, that the licenses, Creative Commons licenses are paper free licenses, international paper free licenses, while this is completely black and white exercise, copyright. Okay, the without signing, copyright is not relevant. You have to give it, at least scanned copy you will have to submit by with your signatures. Then the copyright is, you can say, enforced. Okay.
Again, the question is related to the citation or self-citation. How to cite the definitions, especially medical terms coined by the international bodies? Because they are going to be repeated again and again.
Course.
Yes.
First, we have in the module 3 of plagiarism,
yeah,
we have mentioned that how to avoid the plagiarism. It is the three, if you remember, they were the three major methods, and direct quote is one of the methods. If you are just reproducing a particular exact definition recommended by a agency or a authority.
Authority, whatever, if you can cite in... You can mention it in inverted commas.
Yeah, quotations. Mm. Quotations. This quotations. 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 Under quotes, so, and by mentioning that, which is a source. Mm. Okay.
And when you go for plagiarism check, so it will be excluded.
Yeah, it is excluded, and that you can, okay, if even if it's some software takes it also, then you can easily say that I have already mentioned that it is from this thing, and this is mandatory to mention as such. Okay.
The next question is by Himanshi Vashisht. Sir, can I cite my own paper's phrase in my second paper?
Yeah.
So it is considered as self-plagiarism if you cite your first paper.
But the rules are same.
Lines. Same. Rules will be same. If you will be quoting the same thing, even if your paper is there, because actually, boss, it is not your copyright. You have given the copyright of the
to the publisher.
To the publisher. So okay. Up to 3 lines, up to 39 words, you can take without even for your own work, own previous work. You know, I had to take, I remember an example of my interest review paper. I was preparing another research paper. So I would needed to reproduce a figure, okay, that is general figure, not a research figure of some flavones put together. I had to take the permission from the same publisher that, okay, I want to republish or reproduce this figure into another paper. Then the publisher gave the permission to my paper only to reproduce the same figure to my another paper. Actually, this is the procedure, okay.
Next question is by Jaspreet Kaur.
Jaspreet, welcome.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And the question is, if I take matter from my own thesis to write a paper, will it be considered as self-plagiarism?
Provided you have not already published your thesis in a book form, or you have published some other papers also from thesis.
If you have not produced any papers from your own thesis,
then no issue.
Until your thesis is meant for publication only. Ultimately, you are going to write the papers from your thesis. Okay.
Next question is by Shiv. Can I put paper, figure, table, anything in the thesis without permission? In thesis?
No.
From paper to thesis?
No. Not at all. Even if whether it is your paper or if it is your paper, I think it is permissible. Provided you should mention to your publisher that you have mentioned that you have taken the due permission from the publisher. However, for your thesis work, even a single figure also should not be copied from any other previous source. Okay? Otherwise, it would be in the plagiarism definition. Okay?
So we can conclude these three points from one paper to another paper, from thesis to a paper, and from paper to thesis. So, from paper to paper, you should quote and should be in the limit of 10%. Okay. Yes, sir.
But when you are taking your thesis to paper, obviously you need not to worry. Until unless you have published that particular fraction already. If you have published already, then again it will be paper to paper actually. It is not thesis to paper now. It is paper to paper now you are copying it. And paper to thesis, it is not at all problematic figure. If it is your work, you know, you take my example even, that when I submitted my thesis, my each and every word was published already before submitting my thesis, you know. So I just took that. That is completely permissible. And you will claim that it is the beauty that you have already published the work and it has been peer reviewed before the submission of thesis. So it's wonderful. It never comes in the definition of plagiarism.
Okay. Next question is by Sonia. How many quotes should be cited? Any minimum number suggestible?
Actually, it depends from the subject to subject. From sciences, you can go only a few quotes which are definitions only. You cannot fill the number of quotes and out of your 4,000 word article, you cannot have quote of 1,000 words. Okay? But it matters a lot when you are doing the research on the arts, you are doing the research on Shakespeare, you are doing the work on Tulsidas, Kabir, you are taking again and again the dohas, the lines, the poetry, the sonnet lines, you are taking. So obviously that at that time when you are writing the thesis, it won't be a limitation and it should not be a limitation. Okay? That limitation is not there. So you must have your own filter. Until unless it's the utmost necessary.
You only can decide that how many quotes you should cite in a paper.
But how why?
If you are from arts background, history, political science and all this arts background, then it's okay to cite the quote, but it should be supported with the description.
Obviously, until unless it's the utmost required, you should not use the quote. You cannot use the quotes each and every time. Only when
it's
it is required.
It's not like you will completely keep on writing quotes only.
Otherwise, it will be.
There should be a limit. There should be a limit.
Obviously.
So you only can better judge.
Next question is by Avinash Jadhav. While citing reference from other articles, is it always necessary to paraphrase it, or can we include sentences as it is from referred article? If you are including as it is, you have to quote it.
Yeah, obviously.
You have to quote it.
You have to make it under quote.
Yes.
If you are taking it. And remember, there is a point. You can, in the entire article, you cannot reproduce more than 200 words. Yes. It is the limitation. Okay. 200 words limitation for a particular article I am talking about. Okay. Otherwise, for the under quote, that's when you are taking quotes, it is the definition 3 lines.
39 words.
39 words.
39
words. At a stretch.
Then Pravesh Purthi is asking about 3 lines per 39 word तक quotation, उससे ज़्यादा होने पर
उससे ज़्यादा होने पर
okay that one more related question to this by Himanshi Vasist. Sir, in Turnitin, if a paragraph comes as a plagiarized even after citing it, then what should be done?
Citing, अगर आपके पास citing है, देखिए मैं चलो आपको थोड़ा comfortable करते हैं. I think most of the people are from north. Okay, let's be comfortable. Actually होता क्या है ना कि you will have to, हमारा complete aim क्या है, just be honest, write in your own words, paraphrasing कीजिए ना उसको. अगर citation आपका आ रहा है, quote आपने केवल cite देने से कुछ नहीं होता है कि ये reference मैंने लगा दिया, ये तो मैंने वहाँ से ले रखा है, you have taken each and everything from there. No, you will have to write in your own words. आप अपने words में लिखिए ना, दिक्कत क्या है. देखिए हम कई बार बड़े अच्छे ब्यूटीफुली ढंग से वो बोल जाते हैं किसी अच्छी सी चीज को, अच्छे थॉट को अपने वर्ड्स में बोल जाते हैं, बड़ी आसानी से बोल जाते हैं. यहां क्यों नहीं करते हम, घबराइए मत, अपने शब्दों में लिखिए. साइटेशन करना, रेफरेंस देना प्लेजरिज्म से बचने का साधन नहीं है. ये ध्यान से अपने दिमाग से निकाल दीजिए कि मैंने तो रेफरेंस दे दिया था, नो प्रॉब्लम. नहीं, प्रॉब्लम नहीं है वो प्रॉब्लम वहां खत्म नहीं होती. रादर प्रॉब्लम वहां से पिन पॉइंट होके और इजी हो जाती है कि आपने कहां से ले रखा है. एग्जैक्टली, जैसे हमने कहा कि पैराफ्रेजिंग इज बोथ द कॉज एज वेल एज द रेमेडी. पैराफ्रेजिंग प्रॉब्लम भी है और रेमेडी भी. आपको कैसे यूज करना है, इट्स ऑन यू.
रश्मि रंजन चौधरी इज आस्किंग अबाउट, इज इट नेसेसरी टू इंक्लूड प्लेगरिज्म चेक सर्टिफिकेट फॉर थीसिस एंड जर्नल्स.
यस, मैंडेटरी. आपने शायद प्लेजरिज्म ड्राफ्ट प्लेजरिज्म रूल नहीं देखा क्या 2018 का, हमने आपको एक मॉड्यूल में मेंशन किया. हाँ, अगर आपको पता नहीं है या आपके सुपरवाइजर को पसंद नहीं, तो प्लीज आपके मॉड्यूल में, एक पर्टिकुलर मॉड्यूल के उसी जो प्लेजरिज्म वाले वीक में ही मैंने, हमने इंसर्ट किया है उसमें, हमने प्लेजरिज्म रूल 2018 को इंसर्ट करके आपको लिंक भी दिया है, इंसर्ट भी किया है. आप उसे पढ़िए, देखिए. अगर आप 10% से ऊपर आपका प्लेजरिज्म है तो आपको वापस सबमिट करना पड़ेगा. मेरे ख्याल से कितना है, 40% से ऊपर है तो रिजेक्टेड है, आपका कैंडिडेचर ही रिजेक्ट हो जाएगा. इवन योर सुपरवाइजर इंक्रीमेंट मे बी स्टॉप्ड. आपको तो हो गई, आपके सुपरवाइजर को भी जो है पनिशमेंट मिले. तो प्लीज गो अहेड विद दैट, इट इज वेरी सीरियस.
Yes, beginning from the beginning.
So then at the end it will be very easier for you to get the certificate.
Actually, ऐसा नहीं हो सकता ना कि जब मुझे प्यास लगे मैं कुआं खोदने चलूं, ये नहीं हो सकता. आपको आपको शुरू से करना पड़ेगा. आप जब रिसर्च लिख रहे हैं ना,
keep my eyes on the things from introduction itself. When you start writing introduction, literature review and all these things, so
जैसे कि हमने मेंशन भी किया, होता क्या कि आप लिटरेचर रूम में देख रहे होंगे इस वीक में, आपने हमने मेंशन भी किया, हम ये भूल जाते हैं कि हमने कहां से क्या लिया था. शुरू से उसको नोट डाउन कीजिए और ये देखिए कि कौन सी चीज आपने एज सच लिखी है और कौन सी चीज अपने शब्दों में लिखी, उसमें अंतर रखिए. और शुरू से जब इंट्रोडक्शन आप शुरू से अपने वर्ड्स में लिखना लगेंगे ना, कई बार क्या होता है आपको लगता है कि यू डोंट रिमेंबर एक्चुअली वेदर यू हैव टेकन इट एज सच और यू हैव रिटन इन योर ओन वर्ड्स. ओके, सो रिमेंबर दिस.
Pravesh is again asking, in continue with this discussion, means to adopt paraphrasing if it exceeds 39 words. Paraphrasing is not the only way to write a paper.
Paraphrasing is a different thing. You know, quoting 39 words के लिए quote वो नहीं है. Quoting के लिए है 39 words कि जो जो आप जब कर रहे हैं आप ऐसे कर. Paraphrasing 39 words तक सीमित नहीं. Paraphrasing तो आप करते रहिए.
नहीं, वो ये कहते हैं कि 39 words से ज़्यादा अगर हमें लिखना है तो हम paraphrasing करें, क्या ये सबसे अच्छा तरीका है? ऐसा ज़रूरी नहीं है. लेकिन ऐसा adopt
ये अच्छा तरीका है या नहीं है, ये contextual depend करता है तुम्हारी writing पे कि क्या what you want to write and what you have to write. It depends on that कि
देखियो हो सकता है
कौन से 39 words you will choose to write first.
ये 39 words एक जो है APA का guideline है ना मेरे ख्याल से. यस, तो एपी की गाइडलाइन भाई साहब, अगर आप जो है वो वंदे मातरम का जो है वो लिख रहे हैं, एक पोएम की बात कर रहे हैं जिसको आपने पूरा कोट किया है, वो ऑब्वियसली 39 वर्ड से ऊपर है. आप उसको डिस्क्राइब कर रहे हैं तो आपको जैसे ये सीमा आपको एक लिमिट करने के लिए दी जरूर गई है, लेकिन ये कॉन्टेक्चुअल मीनिंग के लिए कॉन्टेक्चुअल रेफरेंस से चेंज हो सकती है. ठीक है, बट कभी भी किसी भी केस में वो 40% से ऊपर तो नहीं जानी चाहिए. नहीं तो पहले तो 10% ऊपर. देखिए जी, प्लेजरिज्म तो वैसे जीरो होना चाहिए, अब होना ही नहीं चाहिए. ये तो ये है कि चोरी कितने रुपए तक की अलाउड है, लाइक दैट क्वेश्चन है जो कि सर इतना तक चलेगा इतना नहीं. देखिए, एकेडमिक थेफ्ट इज एकेडमिक थेफ्ट, प्रोवाइडेड आप वो थेफ्ट, ये कहते हैं कि अनुमलिक कहते हैं कि भैया मैं मोजार्ट से मैंने प्रेरणा ली, पता चला कि मोजार्ट का पूरा म्यूजिक एज सच कॉपी कर दिया उन्होंने, हिंदी वर्ड डाल दिया उसमें, उसको हम प्रेरणा नहीं कह सकते ना। आपका अपना होना चाहिए आपके अंदर कि कहां वो प्रेरणा है और कहां वो कॉपी हो जाती है।
इन कंक्लूजन ये इस तरीके का बनता है कि पैराफ्रेजिंग आपको बचाने के लिए है, इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि आप शुरुआत ही उससे करें।
Exactly.
पहले आपको कुछ अपना लिखना पड़ेगा।
पैराफ्रेजिंग देखिए लास्ट का उपाय है, बचने का उपाय है, इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि हर चीज आप बचते ही थोड़ा चलते रहेंगे। आप अपना कुछ ओरिजिनल भी लगाएंगे ना भाई, रिसर्च कर रहे हैं तो ओरिजिनल देना है ना आपको कुछ। यू विल हैव टू कंट्रीब्यूट समथिंग नोबल एंड फॉर दैट यू विल हैव टू राइट फ्रॉम योर ओन ब्रेन।
ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन अगेन बाय ऋषिकेश। सर मैम, वन प्रॉब्लम विद सिस्टमैटिक रिव्यू, व्हाइल राइटिंग वी आर एडिंग मेनी रिएक्शंस एंड देयर कंक्लूजंस, बट सिमिलैरिटी इंडेक्स इज कमिंग हाई, डू वी हैव एनी सॉल्यूशन फॉर दैट? प्लीज गाइड।
सिमिलैरिटी इंडेक्स इज कमिंग हाई,
वेरी हाई, रिजॉल्व दैट।
देखिए, अनटिल इट्स रिक्वायर्ड, इक्वेशन के कारण कह रहा ना, इक्वेशन से रिलेटेड है तो वो आ रहा है। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल देखिए, इक्वेशंस को प्रॉपर रेफरेंसिंग तो जरूर कीजिए, लेकिन इक्वेशन को एज सच ना एक सिरे से दूसरी तरफ तक कॉपी मत कीजिए, तो उसको ब्रेक कीजिए चाहिए। यू ब्रेक इट आउट, वो होता क्या कि जब आपने एक सीरीज ए से लेके जेड तक डिटो आप ए से लेके जेड तक कॉपी कर देंगे तो वो ज्यादा सिमिलैरिटी इंडेक्स शो करेगा। यू ब्रेक इट, ओके, यू ब्रेक इट एंड पुट योर ओन वर्ड्स in between that,
yes,
even if it is equation, even if it is equation, then you go for it.
Write don't, x in between in your own words.
Huh, right, and it will split it and that similarity will come down. I hope so. Okay. However, you will have to take due attention and due precaution in practicing this kind of thing.
Can we consider the references which is not directly give inputs to the research subject directly, but gives some light on the overall subject?
Yeah,
interdisciplinary type.
You can give, no issue. It happens rather that you give the references.
So if you are writing a review paper, then you have to take this kind
of. हाँ, obviously in review तो आपको लेने ही पड़ता है.
आपको बहुत सारे ऐसे specific references तो मिलेंगे नहीं जो आपके review paper को systematic review paper को support कर रहे हैं, तो थोड़ा left right
लेफ्ट राइट इन द सेंस कि आप जब होलिस्टिक व्यू देना चाहते हैं, इट्स जस्ट लाइक सीइंग ए थिंग फ्रॉम डिफरेंट एंगल्स, तो उसके लिए आपको थोड़ा इधर उधर तो जाना पड़ेगा ना।
ओके, एक पेपर है तो एक पेपर का कौन सा
आस्पेक्ट आपको। वन मेंबर ऑफ दिस वेबिनार इज सेइंग दैट लीविंग बिकॉज़ आई अंडरस्टैंड ओनली इंग्लिश। Again, there is a question, how many percentage of plagiarism is allowed in thesis in commerce?
No, it's not about thesis in commerce. It is not about thesis in subject.
You go to the 10%
standard, and it is, you please go ahead. You just type in Google UGC plagiarism academic integrity rule 2018. You will see a PDF. Please go through it. And okay, it is just an example of it. In each and every country, there are rules for plagiarism, for academic integrity. Maintain that academic integrity, don't copy. Okay, we'll have to practice that academic honesty.
Sir, Yashashwini Yadav is asking about, please suggest any specific book or website which help researchers during their research in specific subject. Research related books.
Research related, actually, what I refer and what I refer generally, what I prefer and what I refer is Elsevier. You go to the website of Elsevier and Springer. You see the blogs, you follow their Facebook and other social media account. They always come up with the wonderful articles which will facilitate your research, overall research and its presentation. And they give wonderful work. You know, even the Nature article.
Yes.
Go to the Nature article, wonderful thing. You will come to know that too, interdisciplinary approach and holistic overview of doing the research. You will come to, you will have to follow their blogs, their social media accounts, and the news. Okay?
Is it safe to use free plagiarism checkers sites? Asked by Pulakesh Pradhan.
Actually, in free software account as ma'am have mentioned,
there is a capping, always a capping, yes.
Always a capping. So yes. You cannot
use more than 1,000 words.
And no article, I think, no. Even the short communications are more than 1,000 words. Okay. So there is no question. However, you should not, even if your question was that whether we can rely on.
Safe.
To be very honest, they are not very much safe.
No, yes. And why to go to these sites? I think Google, the official which your university provides.
If you are in university, please talk to your librarian. In India specifically, each and every university is given the exclusive access of Urkund ID, and the, all the faculty, if you are a student, you won't be having the ID.
It will be authentic.
You are a faculty member, your teacher, your supervisor are eligible to get a free Urkund plagiarism ID from your library if you are having if you are in Indian universities. Okay. And in other many universities of Indian universities are having the subscription of Turnitin. Many universities, I went to GGU Hisar, Jambeswar University Hisar, but they are having Turnitin institutional subscription.
Most of the IITs, IIMs, they have
their subscription.
Turnitin subscription.
And get it done through your supervisor. And it is very easy process. So if you know any faculty member, you can just send your article to his or her institutional ID directly. Okay, then it will be automatically scanned, and then he or she may send you back with the report.
So this we have explained in one module.
You please go ahead.
And so, what is the use of free plagiarism checkers? For basic understanding, you can just practice there.
It is just for practicing,
yes,
you know.
It's just
that how it works. Actually, we have given this thing.
Small write-up.
Actually, if you are a student, it is none of your business that how it works. It is meant for supervisors, faculty members, and researchers. Okay?
And we have already discussed it in modules.
Ma'am has discussed it in an exclusive video that what is done and how it is done for analysis of that similarity.
So next question is by Anuraj. Can we interpret in our own words instead of simply quoting if the art field to avoid plagiarism?
Obviously, this is the fantastic thing. This is the most preferred thing. You must stick to your own word.
Can we use the image as it is some common source with citation while writing the general? Ramadosh.
Common source.
Yes, common source. Like Wikipedia?
Okay, provided you please see in that page whether CC license is there or not. CC by SA is written there or not. Unless it is there, don't
CC
copy.
By SA is very common.
It's a creative common license. If you have gone through, I think we have, that's why we have given in very advanced the introduction to open educational resources. You might have observed that they are the creative common license which are available for 5 hours. Retain, reuse, revise, remix. Okay, so this for redistribution, all these things, a CC license provided which gives you the access, free access. So only take the images from CC by SA or Creative Commons websites.
Okay, next question is by Yashashwini Yadav. What's about statistical data, as I understood it? Can it be covered under plagiarism if written?
Statistical data.
It will be covered. Plagiarism is statistical data, and if it's of someone else's research paper, you can't take those data and use.
Data aap nahi le sakte. Even P ka value, jis tarah se aap mention karte hai, even if you mention it in a particular footnote, a particular style you have copied that fellow has taken this thing and you have just mentioned
and
that.
Statistical data, if you want to mention in introduction, then you can give reference and you can mention.
If you are quoting that.
If he wants to put some statistical data in introduction or in description.
Then it's okay, but if you want to be sure that okay, there are 1.2 million of Indian dying with that particular disease every year as per this particular site, so you mention the particular reference and give the statistical data. There again, don't try to mimic or don't try to copy exact line. Here also, put it, the data may be same, but you can put it in your own way, okay?
If I prepare article from my thesis, then can I use same table as I use in my thesis?
Obviously, if you have not taken it earlier from any other source.
If you have not used it for your earlier publication.
Okay? So you can take.
If you are using it first time, go for it, no problem.
Even if you have taken it. Even if you have presented in a oral presentation in a seminar, you can do it, no issue, provided it has not got published in that particular format.
There should not be a documented evidence earlier of this.
perfect thing.
Rashmi Karmakar is asking, does percentage of plagiarism differ institution to institution?
No. It's from
in India
it doesn't vary. I again emphasize, you please write UGC academic integrity rules 2018. That is a gazette notification. You see, it is applicable to all the universities and institutions of India. Okay, and that is same for all the institutions. Okay.
Mr. Rajay is asking, best tool for plagiarism check.
Best tool for plagiarism check.
Plagiarism check will be
which is available to you.
Whatever is available to you. We cannot say that. Because for a particular single work, you are not going to buy a subscription. So obviously, what you can do, you can have a collaboration. If you are any friend and any colleague is there, your supervisor is there, your teacher is there, you can send the file to him or her who is having the access and get it checked for plagiarism from him or her. Because you cannot have, as a student, you cannot have access, okay, until you purchase it.
So Megha is asking, on the basis of secondary data, can we write articles? Is it considered plagiarism?
Yeah.
In general, we use secondary data.
You take the secondary data only. So it doesn't matter. Even when you are writing the meta-analysis data, you take that secondary data only. That provided that the presentation of data should not be as such. Okay. You will have to, you know, modulate the things in a particular way, so that it creates a unique body of knowledge.
Yes.
This is the key point.
Okay, next question is, can a document checked more than one time in plagiarism softwares?
Yeah, you can check. Yes. But remember, in Urkun, what happened with us when we were using very initially, we submitted a particular file and see, okay, there is a, say for example, 30% was their plagiarism. Okay, when we again did it, all the paraphrasing and all that, right, but there are the things we should modulate, and we again submitted it, okay. Then it showed 100%, then it showed 100%, it increased, rather than decreasing, it increased. What happened? Actually, there is a function, you will have to unclick that, do not
exclude, you have to exclude
which have been submitted earlier, okay. और always remember, sometimes होते की गलती हो जाती है, we forget that this thing, so we learn from our own mistake. That's why I'm giving this example of myself only.
As far as I know, sir, all the providers of these similarity reports, they have their repository, own repository, and when you submit any document, they ask you to whether they can put it in their repository or not. If you allow them, then in the next time when you will scan the same document, it will show plagiarism. Okay, if you deny the submission of your document in their repository, then it will be treated as a fresh submission.
Yes. But you have to exclude this from their repository. So always remember that there is always a function. It may differ from one software to another software, that where that
command. I have
command
explained you in Urkund Wala software, the complete description. Just go through from that module.
Yes. This is a voice over there in which ma'am has explained the thing.
I think it's week 3 module.
And just one thing, but I want to clear. I observed, Lokesh, that that Urkund ID has metamorphosized.
Yes.
It is new now. Mm. What you have to do, whatever we have told to you is in the old form. You just have to click use the older version.
Yes.
So it will be same thing. Okay. Mm. It doesn't matter. Don't worry that Urkund, some person may ask that, sir, it is entirely different. No, it is not entirely different. Just
the user interface is changed.
Just user interface is changed.
You can just go. In
right top right corner there is a portion.
Okay. The next question is Zamiro. Sir, if I translate informations or articles from my own language to English and use for my thesis, is it plagiarism?
Even if you translate the thing, it is plagiarism. It is just like making a theft and don't get caught. Until you don't get caught, you are not a thief, you are not declared a thief. But if you are caught, you know, even the translation Exact translation is a plagiarism. It, language is not bar.
For that you can take permission.
But for that you for should that take you the permission take. Or you can paraphrase so that.
Like
paraphrase
that. In Kannada, Telugu or something and you want to translate in English and so it will be a complete new thing.
But you know, things are coming day by day. At that time, a few years back, there was no software to detect the image plagiarism. Nowadays, you are having the things there, even in the Google, to have the image plagiarism checked. Okay? Can you go through that thing? Please explore it.
One more thing I would like to share to all the viewers. जब भी हम प्लेजरिज्म की बात करते हैं तो ऐसा नहीं होता कि आपने एक शब्द कोई लिखा है किसी थीसिस से और वो उसे प्लेजरिज्म में रखेगा. जो भी हमारे पास सॉफ्टवेयर्स हैं अभी तक या जितने भी हमारे प्रोवाइडर्स हैं सिमिलैरिटी रिपोर्ट के, उन सबके पास कुछ टेक्निक्स हैं. इनमें सबसे जो फेमस टेक्निक है दैट इज बैग ऑफ वर्ड्स. बैग ऑफ वर्ड्स वो आपके कुछ पूरे आर्टिकल से कुछ शब्दों को सेलेक्ट करते हैं, उनका एक की जनरेट करते हैं और उसको मैच करते हैं दूसरे आर्टिकल से जो उनके रिपोजिटरी में अवेलेबल हैं. जब ये मैचिंग हो जाती है उसके बाद में आपके डॉक्यूमेंट में प्लेजरिज्म शो होता है. आप लोग अभी कई लोगों ने ये सवाल पूछे हैं जैसे टाइप 2 डायबिटीज, फाइब्रोमायल्जिया, इस तरह के वर्ड्स को लेके भी सिंगल सिंगल वर्ड्स को लेके प्लेजरिज्म शो होता है. ऐसा नहीं है. आप ये देखेंगे कि टाइप 2 डायबिटीज जिस आर्टिकल से या जिस सोर्स से आपने लिया है उसी से रिलेटेड अदर इंफॉर्मेशन भी आपके पेपर में इंक्लूड होती हैं और वो क्यूमुलेटिव एक प्लेजरिज्म की तरह या क्यूमुलेटिव सिमिलैरिटी आपको शो करता है कोई भी सॉफ्टवेयर. सिंगल सिंगल वर्ड्स को वो कभी ट्रैक नहीं करते. तो आप ये ध्यान रखें कि उसमें जो लिमिटेशन है, वही जो सर बता भी रहे हैं इतनी देर से, कि आपके 3 lines 39 वर्ड्स, इससे नीचे ही आप किसी भी एक पर्टिकुलर आर्टिकल से डायरेक्ट material use करें.
You know, there are the AI, the yes. artificial intelligence is being practiced in the Western world even for the class assignment. The AI is being practiced that from first semester whatever you have written in second and in fourth in eighth, it is your standard style is noted. Then artificial intelligence tells that this particular assignment is not written by X because it doesn't match with his or her writing style.
That is stylometry.
So they have reached, the things have reached at the next level.
And this I have explained.
Yeah, string matching and all that, we yes. have already discussed that thing, that how they actually work.
What are the plagiarism checker softwares with unlimited word counts? The services one. Like Urkund, Turnitin,
the purchase versions or
Authenticate. Yes, these are the things.
And please do remember the names, okay? The at least the names of 2, 3, 4. Even when you are going for a interview for your project fellow interviews or for an exam, many times they are asked that what are the things, okay?
Again, Jyoti is asking about.
Yes, Jyoti.
I have already published my thesis into a book, and I wish to prepare article from that. Is it possible?
Technically, it is not possible. Provided, you can take a fraction of that thing.
You can take a fraction of
that. A fraction of that thing and use it as a basis for writing another thing. But you cannot reproduce it. Actually, technically, if your book is not in the public domain, might be you don't got caught by the plagiarism software. But the rule is same there. You technically, or if I say that ethically, it is not right.
You can take a little portion and then you can
prepare the thing or prepare a new article, you can say. But you cannot reproduce it as such.
Okay? It's like in driving a vehicle without license and hoping that you won't get caught by the traffic police and one day you will get a ticket for that.
Obviously. If you have done the crime, always be afraid.
Yes.
You will have to live the life with that fear that you will get caught. You will get caught at any moment. Okay. So please, it is not right actually. However, if this is not published, you can
read
it.
Stay away
from these practices. Hmm.
Reva is asking, in review article with proper citation, even it's considered as plagiarism. because it reaches to the limitation of 3 lines and 39 words?
Actually, writing the review, we will be discussing it in the coming modules, is a very challenging work actually. It seems that, you know, for Tom, Dick and Harry journals, it is very easy to compile here and there and put something there in the form of a review.
Snorri is attending our webinar. My friend from Iran. Hi, Snorri. And she, Dr. Simon is answering all the
questions
in Hindi. Mm-hmm. So, it's difficult for me to understand.
Okay, sorry.
Okay.
So, welcome from Iran. dear friend, academic integrity, you have to maintain and you have to understand. But how you will maintain? First, you will have to understand what does the academic integrity mean. Actually, many times we do the mistake unintentionally. We will have to understand do's and don'ts in academic integrity. First, remember this thing. Ask your supervisor. See your institutional guidelines. See your country's plagiarism guidelines. And then decide what to do and what not to do. Because if you have done something, you cannot redo it many times. It happens. If you have done something wrong, in the case of, you just pray to God that you don't get caught.
Plagiarism may catch you after 10 or 20 or 30 years of your submission of PhD.
It is not like an income tax scrutiny that you have filed the income tax and if 1 year gone.
Time of your life.
Yeah. And the it has been covered by Dr. Mona that many vice chancellors have sacrificed their job.
Studies. There are different case studies. Those case studies are discussed for this purpose only.
You can also share the very interesting stories from your countries and from your know-how in the forum also. Okay, please.
One question is from outside the focus point of our discussion.
Okay.
UGC care list is only important or Scopus or Web of Science Index publication? Can I?
What I feel that just focus to the Scopus and Web of Science. If you are a sciences people specifically, even for non-sciences, there are many good journals. If you are able to publish in those journals which are cited in by the Scopus and Web of Science, it should be a very first priority. Care list of journals.
I want to add, there are 3 categories in UGC care list. The first one includes all the journals, those are listed in Web of Science. Okay. The second category involves all the Scopus index journals. Then the third category comes, and in which those journals who are not included in either Web of Science list or in Scopus list, and they have some importance in the research in national level or in international level, they are included. Okay.
So, that is fine. What we mean to say is that you always target a good thing because it will always be included in any kind of committee. If CARE has taken, that's why the CARE has taken, that had put the Scopus and Web of Science Index journals in the...
As it is.
As a whole. No rule. They say if they are indexed in Web of Science Scopus, automatically it will be there.
How can we use historical facts in our PhD thesis without being labeled plagiarized? Historical facts.
Historical facts, place it in your own words. Again, I will say that, and it is very easy to put the historical things in a form of a story. You might have seen the recent movie Tanaji. It might have been written somewhere in the form of story, but the presentation is unique. The unique presentation makes your work unplagiarized, isn't it?
Andaaz-e-bayan.
हाँ, andaaz-e-bayan आपका खूबसूरत होना चाहिए, andaaz-e-bayan आपका अनूठा होना चाहिए. That is important. The way you present the thing should be unique.
Kindly explain how to write literature review without plagiarism.
In the coming modules?
Yes.
We are going to address it in the coming module.
Very elaborately.
Literature review we are continuing in this week.
Yes.
Lokesh, and this next week also we will be talking about the literature management too. So please go ahead with this week and the coming week. You will come to know each and every aspect of literature. Then in the next webinar we will discuss it surely.
Okay.
If you are don't get your answers in these days.
Next question is by Sri. Can I take literature review from some latest book in similar topic of the thesis.
Yes.
For a thesis, sorry.
You can take notes. Why not?
But you have to recreate it in your own words.
Literature is by Rashmi Ranjan Chaudhary.
Followed table, images, graph from other documents with modification, how to quote or can we modify their work and move forward?
Can we modify their
work, their figures, their tables, their images and move forward, or we have to quote?
Image plagiarism, I think we have discussed it, that it's better to recreate the things, reformulate the thing or modify the thing, and if you have adapted as such, then you should take the permission for a complete table or complete figure. You must take, I had given you my example.
So better go for those images which are CC by SA.
I think Windows is giving the facility.
Yes.
You will search the things, then it will be giving you only the Creative Commons figures.
Microsoft Office.
MS Office, you go, it will search only the Creative Commons figures, which is available for free for reuse. Okay.
Akshay is asking, sir, if I write something somebody else is already wrote, but I did not know they wrote it, is that still a plagiarism? Yes.
Yeah, obviously.
Yes, because I answered this question in about few questions,
Sometimes it happens that you don't know that it has been already stated or not. But actually, what does the plagiarism software does? The same thing. It will let you know that, okay, it has already been stated. Because
there must be something different.
It must be restated, reframed, the paraphrasing is all about this. Okay.
These are all the questions.
Okay.
Till.
Thank you. So we have covered, I think we have almost 1 hour. 10 minutes, just we will just wrap up the things in this 10 minutes. Meanwhile, if you have a question, you can also put in your discussion forum and beneath this, because it will be, this webinar will be available in the YouTube, freely available to you.
You can watch it
and you can share it. You please share it with your supervisor, with your faculty member, with your students and colleagues, and give your feedback. We have given the feedback in the class central, link we have seen. Please rate us so that we can improve, we can get motivated by your thoughts. Okay. So far, academic writing, I am not a perfect, first of all. My team is not perfect. We are just a facilitator. You are the expert of your own field. We just want to recreate, or you can say total recall, that you are capable to do that. So we just want to give some input so that you can do the wonders.
Just to help you.
You can do the wonders at your own, provided you have the inputs. Yes, Lokesh, you are saying something?
Next question is there. Two questions are there. Is there any good source for learning about developing conceptual framework?
Conceptual framework about?
Conceptual framework.
That's the only question.
This is
completely creates.
It's the origin of idea, you mean to say? Origin of idea? Conceptual framework. Actually, about whenever we are talking about the conceptual framework, it depends that it's about the origin of idea, isn't it?
Yeah,
and
it's always better that the conceptual framework is completely original and it's conceptual framework.
And conceptual framework always comes from the brainstorming. You cannot develop your own framework at your own. You will have to discuss it with your peers, with your collaborators, with your team members. Then the idea should come up. Then the concept should be finalized. Okay.
The next question is, how can we cite the information drawn from a source like book where the source is already there?
Pardon?
How can we cite the information drawn from a source like book where the source is already there?
Source वहाँ पहले से है.
Cross-referencing?
Cross-referencing?
Yes.
It is called cross-referencing.
That's I have the references. Yes. You also have answered in the queries, which I have answered in the module module.
And this is the best way, I think, to have the cross references. Provided you must go to the cross references and study the cross references. Okay.
And if you want to cite it, you can write both the references.
Hmm. Best journal for commerce.
Sorry. I'm not a person from commerce. That's why I'm telling you.
No, it's okay. You can find best journal for commerce. But we will go.
We suggest you go to the Elsevier.
Yes.
Elsevier publisher's website. Go to the Springer. Go to the Bentham site. Filter from the journal section, the your commerce, and allied subjects. You will come to know what are the good impact.
Do some literature survey. You will find good journals.
And one more thing, he or she can do. Go to ResearchGate and search for JCR 2019 or 2018. You will get a report with the impact factors list. Okay, and then you can search for commerce journal.
The journal citation report is there, and you can have the journal. Basically, you should be in touch. If you are doing this, the very first thing you must know what are the good journals of your field. Then you should learn the things. So you must have a good idea, aim in your mind that one day I will publish in that particular journal. That kind of spirit a researcher must have. Okay. So for that you must know now where is the aim. So for that, please, that's why we have given the exercise that mention top five journals of your field. So that you can explore, you can brainstorm, you can search what are the ideal things. And there might be some criteria that some good journal might be 40 impact factor, 50 impact factor, but it is beyond your reach, beyond your capability. So always have a segment that, okay, these are the top journals, okay, that's fine. But what are my capabilities? Okay, 1 to 5 impact factor journals, these are the list of journals. But very soon I am going to publish it in that. And the next phase I will publish in from 5 to 10, that impact factor. But your work should be up to that mark, then you can publish it.
One more question is there. Can we repeat some portion of thesis in a different chapter? From one chapter to another chapter,
yes,
can we copy?
Yes, you can do that. Huh? Ek hi thesis mein do chapter ki baat kari. You can repeat. Yes, you can do that. But
why?
Why?
My question is why? Just to increase the number of pages? your question, you know the answer. And you want the endorsement from us. Sorry. No.
Okay, dear learners, 28th February is last day for registration to the Academy Titan. So please do recommend to the PG students of your known and your faculty member, the persons in your, who are in your contact. So 28th February is last day for registration to this course. So registrations are still open. So please do recommend our course.
Hmm.
Rest of the questions?
Himanshi, how to create a
last question,
ID in ResearchGate?
Hmm?
Okay, last question is, sir, when will be the next webinar?
The last webinar we will in our last cycle we did a good number of webinars.
In the first run of the course,
but due to some internet problems we could not do so far. Otherwise, we would have done at least once in 2 weeks. Okay,
but we have started podcasting, no sir?
We have started. That's why we have started podcasting.
Podcasting.
We will be giving the links for your audio. Even for those people who are unable to attend it, we are recording this audio and we will be giving this audio only. Also, apart from the YouTube, it will be recorded in the YouTube form and the podcast will also be there for this thing. Okay. So be in touch. We will give you the feedback. Please don't forget to give the feedback. Okay. And do recommend the course to your peers, to your contacts. So we will be coming with the webinar very soon.
And you will be informed quite
early. At least 3 days.
Three days. You will be informed and you will be...
And sorry to say, we won't be able to do it on the off days. We will do the webinar. It is our compulsion to do it in the office hour only.
Office hour is working
day.
Right?
Yeah, working day office hour. So please spare the time. And even if you are not able to do, you are not able to attend, what you can do, you can put the queries ahead of the start of the thing and then we will answer it. You will get the answer. You can see the recorded version in the YouTube. We will be sharing that YouTube. And we forget to look at one thing, that apart from this, whatever the webinar we have talked to today, the similar webinar on the plagiarism we have done in the next cycle and other
previous cycle.
In the previous cycle. So what we are doing, that we will be making a entirely new unit in which the lessons will be of previous webinars and so far webinar, whatever we will do in this cycle and whatever we have done in the previous cycle, we will, that those webinars will be given for your access.
For your access and for your reference. So you just go through from those webinars. So you have in the,
that's why we haven't opened so far, because now taking for the when we will be talking about the next webinar, the same topics webinar will be there, okay, in your that dashboard. So what you do, you see it,
go through it,
might be you will be having your answers already there. Even if some answers are, some questions are remaining to be answered, please come up with those questions prepared in that webinar, okay, and this will be very helpful to you.
And rest of the questions,
rest of the question will be taking the discussion forum and this.
Yes, please, this only. Please share your questions in discussion forum and we will
discussion forum, or you can also discuss, you can in the comment box of this when it will be available.
Yes, in discussion forum it will be shared to everyone.
It will be better
to write your question in the discussion forum and we will try to answer there. And
I think you are getting the answers, isn't it? In the discussion forum. Most of the people are adding. This time we have targeted that we will address 100% of that queries. Okay. So friends, thanks for being with us. Bye bye for now from the team AW. Hope you will keep on learning with us. Okay. So it's bye bye from Lokesh, Dr. Mona, and myself.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you. Bye.